It's technology.
Hello, welcome to Northern Uganda. Today, I have my very good friend, Teacher Cinderella.
Hi, Sheba. Hi, everyone.
Teacher Cinderella works with an organization called Oysters and Pals Uganda.
Oysters and Pals Uganda is an edutech organization that teaches students how to use science, technology, math, and engineering to create projects that can help to solve community problems. Do you want to see a makerspace?
What is a makerspace?
Come and I'll show you.
Amazing!
This is a makerspace, a special place where students make projects. Do you want a tour?
Absolutely! Wow, that's an interesting robot! What does it do?
This is Voyer. It's a voice command robotic arm. You can tell it to do anything and it'll do it for you.
This is Innocent. She's in the team which created this project.
Hello everyone. Call me Ama Innocent and this is a Voyer. It's a French word which means voice. This robot functions with the voice. It's an app which you get from the phone and then you give your instructions to the phone. Then the robot performs the instructions.
All right, let's try it.
Yeah, you can try it.
What do I have to say?
You have to give the command, like for example, if you want it to go back, tell it back. If you want it to go forward, tell it front.
Up?
No, it won't work because that's not the command given to it.
Raise.
There we go.
Wow. Lower. So what is this one about?
This is a flexi glove. It helps in the rehabilitation of stroke patients. And this is Mercy. She has been working on this project for the past 1 month and they have just come up with the first prototype. And I think you can try it on. So this is the exoskeleton. The stroke patient is going to wear this. Since for them they can't move their hands, they need something for them to move their hands. And then this are flex sensors, as you can see. These ones are the ones which are programmed, and they are programmed in such a way that they can control this. My hands are okay, but her hands are not fine. So if I move these flex sensors, they're able to bend and go back to their original position. So if I bend this, her hands are also supposed to bend. If we keep doing this for some good time, she's going to be able to regain her mobility again.
That's actually the biggest robot we have here. Thank God you have noticed. Come and I introduce you to Terra.
All right. Hello.
Hi.
So this is Terra and this is Joshua and Victor. They're the ones who have been working on Terra.
It can do movements in a lot of positions from the robotic arm, as you can see. And then given these two chain wheels, it can move forward and backward, and then can turn in any direction. Give it right or left. Then take a look at this hand. It can grab something or catch something, then drop it down.
We also used a couple of materials that can locally be sourced. For example, we used wood, plywood, and we used some bits of acrylic. There's some plastic called acrylic, as you can see the grip. The bicycle parts, if you can see the wheels, they're made of chains, and then gears from the printer parts. You can see it has the storage containers in case, you know, it's picking multiple packages, it can pick, and then the arm turns, will be powering it, the arm turns, and then it drops in one of the packages.
We have learned so much today. We have seen some robots and also discovered that robots are machines built by human beings to perform different tasks. Thank you so much, Cinderella, for taking us through your beautiful makerspace.
You're welcome, and thank you very much for visiting. Hope you had fun and learned a lot. Bye.
Bye.